I don't normally share a lot of things that are really personal. But what happened to me? You know, I used to be a tough son. What happened?
You know they call me Santa Claus now, right? Because I only come out once a year.
That's all you need to. You look great.
Wow.
Here I am, you know, at this late point in my career, and I'm wondering, am I going to be able to hang with this young guy?
Okay.
Well, but I'll keep that.
Keep it in mind. Just let one of us know, okay? And
really? You really can't kayfabe 10 minutes?
Oh, Bob, screw your camera guy.
I was trying to figure out, because I knew I wasn't anywhere close to being at 100%, I was trying to figure out how to make it work.
All right, let me,
That's a huge challenge to only work once a year and to try to have timing, cardio, have your gimmick, you know. I mean, it's tough, it is. But it's my reality. I mean, that's where I'm at. At this point in my career, I can't work a full schedule. There, I said it. I love and respect this business so much. And all I ever wanted to be was I wanted to be a wrestler, you know. And would I have imagined, you know, the success of that character and the longevity? There's no way.
Look at the size of that ham hock!
I don't think I've ever been so drawn to a character so immediately. It never felt like a performance. It just felt like someone tapping into his inner self and bringing it out to the public.
Austin with a clothesline, 360 by the Undertaker, and he is still standing.
I always thought like Frankenstein, like it was like, you couldn't do much to him.
Have you ever seen anything like this before?
He became what he envisioned the Undertaker would be.
Oh! Whoa! Uh-oh.
In every sense of the word.
Rest in peace.
It was less is more. The pace of my matches was extremely slow. And then, bang. Something really fast, to, like catch people off guard, like, whoa, I didn't know he could move like that. The eye roll, that just happened in a match. I think it was Greg Valentine I was working. Had him down in the corner. I was just rolled back in my head. When I came back, and everybody was like, what the hell was that?
The Undertaker walking that top rope and down!
It goes all the way back to his love of what we do and his love of performing. What he was willing to sacrifice, it was what he was willing to do.
What in the world? Never seen that in my life!
He gave it everything he had.
was 300 pounds and just a big son of a gun.
Good God, sir! I'm so sad!
And could move in a way and do stuff that men his size shouldn't be able to do.
There's the Undertaker! Oh, my God!
And people fell in love with the character. They also fell in love with Mark Calloway because they know he works so hard for them.
The Undertaker receiving a standing ovation from this jam-packed capacity crowd.
And there have been a lot of men who have held that belt undeservingly. And I can say with all truth, that man deserves to be exactly where he's at.
And how fitting that it happened at WrestleMania!
WrestleMania is just, I mean, that's it. I mean, that's the creme de la creme in our industry. And for me, it's big time. I mean, it is.
You are looking at the most incredible performer in WrestleMania history.
Just happened, man. Someone brought it to my attention. Somebody said, you know, you're undefeated at WrestleMania. I'm like, well, really? Oh, that's cool.
The streak took on a life of its own.
Ladies and gentlemen, the legend of The Undertaker continues to grow.
It really added a great element to each WrestleMania.
If there was a totem pole, Taker was at the top of the totem pole. He was the best. He was the highest you're going to get. I think I earned his respect that night. And to earn Taker's respect, you've arrived.
To be given that opportunity, you knew, okay, they trust me. He trusts me with this baby.
Oh my goodness!
That is the streak.
Who would have thought that one man could make so many WrestleManias to even be able to put himself in the conversation to make that happen?
Every match was different and unique in its own way.
I am not believing this!
It became this unbelievable moment every year that you look forward to and look forward to being a part of.
Can you say 21 and 0?
Quite frankly, I mean, the streak is what made it okay for me to only work once a year, you know, because I had to defend the streak. I mean, it takes its toll. I had a 5-year stretch or so there where my schedule would be I would prepare for Mania. I would have my Mania match. Then I would have some kind of surgery to repair whatever had been bothering me going into that match, and then go straight from rehab right into training to be ready to go into Mania again.
People have no idea how much pain he's in physically and how much pain he tolerates and how many surgeries he's had. It's just, they don't understand.
Stay healthy, man. Keep running up that road again.
Run to the wheels fall off.
To weather through everything that he's weathered through because he loves this business speaks volumes. To sum it up, he's a tough son of
at this point, every year, that's kind of the big issue, is of making sure that there's always enough gas in the tank, and that's kind of a product of only working the few matches that I do now. Everything that I I'm dealing with now, so. Yeah, it's a it's a kind of a crazy web I weave, trying to, you know, train effectively and get, you know, to get the maximum results I can with what I'm working with.
This is always the most nerve-wracking workout because it's the last workout before the match. You always fear some type of injury 2 days before the biggest match of the year. I want to stay fluid, keep the muscles elongated. Stay focused and get what you have to get done, done, and get out.
Regardless of my injuries, regardless of my age, regardless of everything that's happened, if I'm on the card, there's some young guy that's making a lot of, you know, the shows through the year, you know, that may not be on that card. So it's my duty to make sure that it's worth putting me on the card. No one would probably say anything to my face if I stunk it up, but I would know. And, you know, that's one of my biggest fears, and is kind of becoming a parody of myself. I always think this way. It would kill me to know, like, some dad who watched me when he was young has to turn to his son and go, man, yeah, I mean, he's moving kind of slow now, but man, you should have seen him, you know, you should have seen him 10, 15 years ago. You know, that's just like, you know, I know reality is that, yeah, I've slowed down, but still, I try to bring the best package that I can on that night. So just because like I said, it would just kill me if I was, you know, like, yeah, you should have seen him win, you know, and not what he is now.